Welcome back. In the previous video, you saw the fundamental theorem of calculus. Roughly, it says that integration and differentiation are inverse operations. In this video, I would like to show you why this theorem is true. Let me first show you why differentiation and integration are related. Let us consider a continuous function f that we integrate from a to b. Recall that when you integrate, you are actually calculating a signed area between a graph, the x-axis, the line x equal to a, and line x equal to b. Let's call the signed area s. Now let us make the upper boundary variable. To stress this, let's replace b by a more standard variable name. We cannot use x, since it's already used in the integral, so let's use t instead. If t varies, so does the signed area, which we stress by writing s of t. My claim is the derivative of s is equal to f. So why is this? Well, if we change from t to t plus delta t, then s changes, let's say, by an amount delta s. Now delta s is precisely the area of the small strip in the picture. Let's zoom into this strip. If delta t is small, then the strip is roughly equal to a rectangle with width delta t and height f of t. So delta s is approximately equal to f of t times delta t. We can make this approximation better by taking delta t smaller. It follows that the quotient of delta s and delta t is approximately f of t. And this becomes exact if we let delta t tend to zero. The limit of delta t to zero of the quotient is equal to f of t. Now, if you remember the video on differentiation, then you see that the quotient is precisely a difference quotient for the function s, and the limit of the difference quotient is exactly the derivative of s at t. So we see the derivative of s is precisely f. Equivalently, we can say that s is a primitive function of f. This already shows that differentiation and integration are related. How does the fundamental theorem, as we phrased it, follow from this? Well, we have seen that s is a primitive function of f. Furthermore, note the following. S of a is by definition equal to the integral from a to a of f. If upper and lower boundary of an integral coincide, the integral is zero. More about that in the next subsection. S of b equals the integral from a to b of f, again, by definition. Since s of a is zero, we can simply subtract and get that the integral from a to b of f equals s of b minus s of a. This is precisely the fundamental theorem for the particular primitive function s. The only thing is that the fundamental theorem holds for any primitive function. So, to end, suppose that capital F is any other primitive function of f. We have seen in the previous video that s and f must differ by a constant. So s equals f plus c. Now we can rewrite the expression that we just obtained. Replace s of a by f of a plus c, replace s of b by f of b plus c, and subtract. The c's cancel, and we are left with f of b minus f of a. To summarize, we have found that for any primitive function capital F of small f, the integral from a to b of small f is equal to capital F in b minus capital F in A. This is precisely the statement of the fundamental theorem of calculus.